Now we move on to the members of the UTEC Executive. So the UTEC Campus Council is as follows. In the position of President, we have Denver Sappleton. That is President of the UTEC Campus Council, Denver Sappleton. Next up, in the position of Programs, we have Nisha Ann Moyston. That's Programs, Nisha Ann Moyston. Then we have the Missions Director for the UTEC Campus Council, Ms. Shanike Newman. That's Missions, Shanike Newman. Then the Secretary for the UTEC Campus Council, Ms. Michelle McFarlane. That's Secretary Michelle McFarlane. Then we have the Treasurer. The Treasurer for the UTEC Campus Council is Mr. Tevin Taylor. That's Treasurer Tevin Taylor. Up next is Communications. The communications person for the UTEC Campus Council is Ms. Jamila Spence. That's Communications, Jamila Spence. Lastly, the Food and Social Coordinator is Mr. Romanio Edwards. That's Food and Social Coordinator, Romanio Edwards.
The General Fellowship Executive. Creative Arts Director, Thomas Connell. Thomas Connell. Communications Director, Romario Daniel. Romario Daniel. Treasurer, Garshel Kelly. Garshel Kelly. Secretary, Noemi Ortiz. Noemi Ortiz. Missions Director, Brandon Gilbert. Brandon Gilbert. Programs Coordinator, Malaika Booth. Malaika Booth. And President, Matthew Daniel White. Matthew Daniel White.
Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, and dare I say, celebration, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Brothers and sisters, we need to fully give our lives to God. And with that, all our trials, because with our lives come trials. And if we're giving our lives to God, that means we have to give him our trials also. We can't claim to serve a risen Savior, a Redeemer, a Provider, a Waymaker, and yet, like Peter, when we become unsure of him keeping us afloat, we start to sink in our storms of despair and misery. Where is our faith? Where did our trust go? Are we letting our trials become testimonies? Are we rejoicing before the sun begins to shine again? Or do we idly wait on the sun with our heads bowed low? What is your attitude while you wait? I charge you today, celebrate while you wait. God has promised that he will not give you more than you can bear, and he will take you through your storms. He will take you through the waters, and they will not overflow you, through the fire, and you will not be burnt. So celebrate while you wait. And as we continue through celebrating through our trials, we're going to be listening to persons. We're going to be listening to Jephthah Cole and Malaika Booth. They went through their trials, and through their trials, they came out celebrating, giving God thanks for what he has done for them. And so should we, when we come through our trials, give praises to God, celebrate, and let others know that God is indeed good, and he will take them through just like he has taken you through. We will now listen to Jephthah and Malaika.
Hey, good day everyone. My name is Jephthah Cole, and I'm a first year student at the University of the Commonwealth Caribbean, UCC. I'm here to share my journey through the year 2020. Just like everyone, I have set my goals and dreams for the year, but at the same time, no one have ever planned for a pandemic to take place. This pandemic has set many of us back, And by that meaning back, I mean backward. And because of that, many of us dreams are already crushed. But nevertheless, once you fear God, all things is possible. I could have lose my life throughout this year because of a car accident. Throughout that time period, I have to give God the praise and thanks that He has given me. And not just that, I also lose my job. But without God, I don't know where could I be at this moment. Because God is my Redeemer, my guide, and He is my Savior. I started university. That's one big step for me in my life at this moment. I've never think or dream of starting it through this time period, especially through this pandemic. And although I'm not working, I still manage to pay for my full tuition fee. I know God has done it for me in the past, and I know He can do it for me again in the future. As all the Bible put it, in Proverbs 16 verse 3, commit whatever you do to the Lord and He will make it succeed. And verse 9 said, a man planting his heart and God guides his step. To me, when I read those scriptures, those tell me what God has done for me. I pray for Him, I pray to Him, whatever that I have, plans that I have for the future, whatever plans that I have to go forward, I put it before God first, knowing that through faith, He will make it succeed. And I have my plans that I always wanted to go through, but I know that God is guiding my step. Whatever doors that He opened, I know it is His guidance. And if any door that He shut, I still know God is guiding me and leading me in the right path. Now, my encouragement to all of you, we know that we have our plans for this year, yet this pandemic has set us back. Never fear, God is there and He will show you the way no matter what you are going and what you are facing. Let God be your guide. So as I come to you, my friend, continue to press on, continue to be hopeful because God is on our side. Amen.
I will sing to the glory of God. Oh. His praises in the morning, brand new mercy every dawning. Melody, harmony, I will sing. Sing His praises in the morning, brand new mercy every dawning.
And I'm just here to talk to you about my testimony and what it has been like for me to be celebrating through the storm. No doubt. 2020 is really rough, and it has taken a toll on all of us, mentally, physically, financially, spiritually especially. And I want to just focus on the spiritual aspect for this, because I think one of the devices that the enemy has been using, especially during this time, is fear. And fear is something that once it takes root in us, it can cause us to be in a place where we are doubtful and we're anxious and we worry about the future. We worry because there's so much uncertainty surrounding us. And that's a device of the enemy, because the enemy wants us to be in a place where we doubt what God can do and we doubt what we know God is capable of doing in our lives. And so I want to encourage somebody that if you're fearful because things are not going the way you expected to, you're fearful because you've lost your job, you're fearful because your children are not okay, you're fearful because you don't know what's going to happen in the future, you're doubtful and you're fearful because you just feel alone and you feel as if God isn't there, I just want to encourage you to hold on to the promises of God. I know that you have had circumstances in the past where you felt as if there was no way out, and God made a way for you. And if he made a way for you in the past, He's gonna do the same thing again, because our God doesn't change. He is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And I just ask that you will celebrate and you'll praise through your fears, and that you will pray your worries away, because God is going to come through for you, child of God. Abba takes care of His children, and I'm certain that He's going to take care of you too. And God says in His word that, look here, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And He also says in Isaiah 41 verse 10 to 13 that He is God and that He will uphold you with His righteous right hand. So even as you're going through this period, remember God is upholding you with His righteous right hand, even if you can't feel it, even if you can't see it. And I also want to propose this to you, that probably you are in your graduation season. What do I mean by that? Meaning that God wants you to graduate to new heights and new levels of trust and faith and obedience in Him. And because of that, that's why you feel as if you're being tried. That's why you feel as if you're being tested. But remember that nothing that God does is fruitless or purposeless. He wants to produce fruit and beauty out of your situation. So hold on, trust Him, and He will come through for you. All right, take care and be blessed.
Somebody testify indeed. Indeed, we ought to give God praise. We ought to be testifying through our waiting season. And we're going to be celebrating through our trials. So those of us on YouTube, I want you to just type in the chat right now using the hashtag celebrating through our trials. You're going to be sharing your testimonies with us online, and you're going to be using that hashtag when you're sharing your testimony, celebrating through the trials. And if there is anybody right here, right now, anybody in here, in Andrews SDA Church right now, who has something that they want to give God thanks for, just raise your hand. If you want to come and give God a praise for something he has done, right, so everybody raise their hand and know when you're to come and testify. Nobody wants to come and testify. But those on YouTube, share your testimonies with us in the chat and use the hashtag celebrating through our trials.
Got joy in my soul, God is in control. I got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. This means war. This means war. This means war. I've got joy in my soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. This means war. This means war. This means war. I bleed the blood. I bleed the blood. I bleed the blood. I bleed the blood. The storms and the rain, but the blood still stays the same. Whatever's going wrong, my war clothes are on. I might be in a daze, but you can't have my praise. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. This means war. This means war. This means war. You can't have my family. You can't have my increase. You can't have my breakthrough. You can't have my, you can't have my, you can't, I bleed the, blood. I bleed the blood. I bleed the blood. I bleed the blood. This means war. 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 This means war.
Continue to share your testimonies in the chat with us using the hashtag celebrating through our trials. Alexia Gordon says, God made a way when many times I couldn't, celebrating through trials. Sheldon Marshall, many times I knew I didn't have, but God, because I never lacked. How many of us can give that testimony that there were times when you didn't see the food, you didn't see the tuition, but you never lacked because God always came through right on time? So continue to share your testimonies with us in the chat using the hashtag celebrating through trials. Matthew White, even when things seem like they're falling apart and you're ready to give up and quit, God comes through right on time, every time. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him and He will make straight your paths. I think most of us know this text very well and we can repeat it very well too. But how often do we actually think on the strength and power of these words? When the trials come, we oftentimes question, why me, Lord? Most time, unprepared for this specific trial or storm, we contemplate if we have done something wrong to be on the downside. I know I've done this. I've been in pain many times, like literal pain. And I'm like, God, what me do? What caused this, God? What could have caused this pain? We tend to question, what wrong have we done to deserve this? But these are times when we should let our faith stand tall and we should trust in God. We should not let our faith desert us at that time. Where did the concept of leaning on and acknowledging God go during these times? We read and know the scriptures, but how often do we act on them? And that is an important thing. We know and we can repeat the scripture, but how often do we actually act on the promises, stand on the promises, claim the promises that are there in scripture? When trials come or storms come, we tend to focus more on the negatives. We focus like Peter on the rain and thunder, the wind and the struggles, instead of letting it be an opportunity to put God to the test. Exercise patience. Use your faith and let it be a learning experience to grow in godly wisdom. Brothers and sisters, visiting friends with us on YouTube, let God be your umbrella and most of all, that fortress of strength that we can always lean on.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Yes, not just talking to the people on YouTube.
Strength is perfect when I
power that he holds. When we truly see how deep our weakness goes, his strength in us begins, where ours comes to and proves again. His strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on.
Try Me Trials by Rajni Frey. Have you ever been stressed out or felt broken? Like you're under the thumb of oppression, and though you don't have any visas, you're in a state of depression. You know you're single and you were open for a spirit-filled member of the opposite sex, but the only thing that seems to have ice for you are trials and tribulation, and your spirit's just vexed. Then you get here to this moment, and things flow as smooth as the evening breeze. And suddenly you realize that those days were made for these. I say praise the Lord when these trials try me, because now I have an opportunity for a testimony. And I can declare that God is for me. The truth is, life isn't always sunshines and rainbows. But you should know that before the rainbow was the flood. The point is, sometimes you gotta go through some bad before you can get to the good. Someone once said, life is 10% what happens and 90% how you react to it. See, that then means every trial has a lesson and a blessing in it. And there can be a profit from life's deficits. Remember Paul and the thorn in his flesh? He wanted it out, but God taught it for the best. So the next time trials come and you say, why me, trials? Don't say that. Say, try me, trials. Because through fires, gold is made pure. Through affliction, we can be made more. Caterpillars go through so much, but in the end, their wings unfold. So you can see life as an half-empty glass and live like a wrecking ball chained to your past. Or you can see it half full and come through your trials like a raging bull. COVID came, and for some, the panic meant mass hysteria and panic. For some, it meant prayer and Bible study becoming supersonic. In a storm, Jesus spoke calm. So remember, when you're in your crucibles, you're still engraved in his palm. You're probably up to your neck in worry right now, and your body don't seem to listen, even though your eyes say, shh, it's night now. Because your darkest days are upon you. But is it something you're in or going through? Because if it's something you're going through, it means there's an end to it. There's a light up ahead, but you just haven't seen it yet. But you can take solace in the fact that his promise is a rod and a staff to comfort you in the valley of the shadow of death. In this walk with Christ, it's a walk for life. A walk of sacrifice. Don't let the pain just walk into your life, wreak havoc, and walk away. No, you need to collect pay. No, it means you gain through the pain. Or what do they call it? You earn while you learn. I imagine someplace, somewhere, trials are walking to and fro, saying, "Inny, mini, mine, mo." Looking for where next day will be. If it picks you, don't say why me, trials. Say, come on, trials, try me. Cause my God is a great refiner, and with my God every trial has a timer. Hey, Job said, though you slay me, yet still will I praise you. We should be saying, though this world tries to bring me down, yet still will I raise you, that all men will be drawn to behold and declare you. No, my problems can't surprise you, and my trials, they don't amaze you. See, when this journey gets hard, reach out and touch the Lord. Think it not strange when you go through things. Think it strange when you don't come out learning anything. Don't rush the process, trust the process. There are many soul destructive ways to seek refuge from a trial. Don't try to find one, because it won't make you beautiful, and beautiful things are formed under pressure. Don't believe me, ask a diamond. God is with you, and that's all you need. Blood comes when I fall down and get cut, but I'm healed when he bleeds. Just remember, it's the harsh light that calls forth a tree from a seed. The saying, you are young, so you are strong. But do you see the alarmingly high numbers of mental woes that do reside, like depression, loneliness, stress, and thoughts of suicide? See, strength takes training, and you only learn to swim when you let the rain in. You can only learn to walk on water by putting your faith in motion when the rain you let in becomes an ocean. You've heard of a walk of shame. Wait till you hear about another walk that will make that one look pretty lame. I'm gonna say something, but before you call me crazy, just wait. Here it is. Our trials are cause for us to celebrate, because we get to do the walk of faith and penetrate the status quo while we meditate and contemplate the flame of God that ever glows and ever grows within. So today you may ponder, where will your next meal come from? Because the cupboards seem dry and your pocket seems porous, but you can still raise in heavenly chorus, knowing full well God promises to secure us. When everything starts to go downhill, let your praise be raised like a string of balloons up Zion Hill. Let this be the last line imprinted on your consciousness and subconsciousness. Trials are a stepping stone to elevation. And since we tend to make a big deal out of promotions, let every trial be a celebration.
We just want to take a break to acknowledge the setting of the sun. So please bow your heads while I pray. Dear kind and most heavenly Father, we thank you for another Sabbath well spent in your courts. At this time, as we pause to recognize the setting of the sun, we know that there is indeed a sunset that is coming. That sunset where all of our trials, all of our pain, all of our crying will be put to an end, because you did tell us that you have the keys to hell and death. You have conquered everything that there is to conquer, and so we await that sunrise. Dear Lord, as we proceed with the rest of the program, we ask that you give everyone listening comfort through their trials, because we know that you turn trials into triumphs and tests into testimonies. We ask that each person receive a blessing here on out. In your name we pray. Amen.
Consider how much I've let you down. I am humbled by the grace you have extended. I'm amazed at the mercy I have found. I could never earn your love on my own, but every time I come before your throne, I stand redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I stand redeemed before the great I am. When he looks at me, he sees the nail-scarred hands that bought my liberty, and I stand redeemed. Even at my best, I am unworthy, and I have nothing precious I can give. A broken life is all that I have to offer, and yet it is a priceless gift to give. The bitter mark of sin will never fade away, but I can come before him unashamed. I stand redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I stand redeemed before the great I am. When he looks at me, he sees the nail-scarred hand that bought my liberty, and I stand redeemed. I stand redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I stand redeemed before. When he looks in me, he sees the nail-scarred hand that bought my liberty, and I stand redeemed. I stand redeemed.
We are indeed redeemed, celebrating through our trials. Nikisha Morgan, I am home from work due to COVID so that I can take care of my son. But I can testify that I have never wanted for anything going into 3 months now. We have not gone without food. Omar Bennett, celebrating through trials. God gives peace in the most challenging circumstances. The trials come to make us strong. He is my hope and peace. Thank you so much for sharing your testimonies with us in the chat using the hashtag celebrating through our trials. Family and friends, I hope the messages of the program this afternoon have provoked your thoughts and will prick you into action to celebrate through your trials. I hope that you believe whatever the trial, whatever the storm, we can celebrate because God is indeed the captain who is in charge of this vessel we call life. And as we sail, it won't always be calm seas and clear skies. The boat will rock, the storms will come, and the sky will get overcast. But let us never forget, the storms don't last forever. And in his word, God has said he will never leave us or forsake us. A promise he will never break. Are you giving total control to God? And as the song says, will your anchor hold in the storms of life? Let us pray. Lord, teach us to celebrate through the storms. Please help us to allow our trials to strengthen us and not to break us. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us learn to wait on the Lord and celebrate while waiting, for this is how we can prove our God. Thank you for worshiping with us this weekend, celebrating through the storm, strengthened by our trials. Tarry with us a little longer for the Vesper Thought as we close this blessed Sabbath weekend.
Hello, good evening everyone. Hi, it's been a very long day and I know that we have been blessed by all the proceedings of this service. So we're going to end this Sabbath evening with a very short Vesper Thought and a hymn. So the rewards of responding with grace, as God faithfully pours out his grace upon us in the midst of each fire trial, we can endure hardships and overcome the enemy in God's strength. Our rewards of responding with grace are gaining the strength of godly character, fellowship with Christ, and heavenly reward. So as you journey through this week, remember that God has assured us that he will not permit us to be attacked with trials and temptations that are too overwhelming for us to handle. He will grant us grace to be overcomers. In 1 Corinthians 10, verse 12 to 13, it says, "Wherefore let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he fall. There hath no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man.
But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above all that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. Amen. Praise the Lord to that. I'm going to invite you to stand with us as we sing hymn number 4. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. To his feet thy tributes bring. Ransomed, healed, restored, forgiven. Who like thee his praise should sing. Praise him, hallelujah. Praise the everlasting King. Third verse. Tenderly he shields and bears us. Well or feeble frame he knows. In his hands he gently cares us, rescues us from all our foes. Praise him, hallelujah. Widely as his mercy flows. Last verse. Angels help us to adore him. Ye behold him face to face. Sun and moon bow down before him. Dwellers all in time and space. Praise him, hallelujah. Praise with us the Amen. Thank you.
Testing, testing. Oh, there we go. All right, you guys may be seated. It's been quite a day, hasn't it been, church? We've heard different messages from morning after morning that have blessed our hearts and inspired our souls. And it is my task at this time to give us the vote of thanks. So I would like to thank, first of all, our supreme God who made this entire thing possible, who carried us through this year 2020 despite many trials and many setbacks. To tell you the truth, even this event did not have to happen because so many things were derailed because of the things going on in this year, but God made it a possibility. God allowed this day to be a success, and for that we give him the highest praise and the utmost thanks. Specifically though, for this Singspiration Chapel weekend, we'd like to thank our planning team, our chairperson, Ms. Ashima Allwood, the program coordinators, Ms. Trishana Andrews, Michelle McFarlane, Danique Newby, Alexia Gordon, and our floor manager, Ms. Shasheen Curtis. We'd also like to thank the members of the General Fellowship Executive of Advent Fellowship for their assistance in ensuring that the program was executed successfully. We'd also like to thank those who helped organize the running of the day. We'd like to thank, say a very big and special thank you to the pastor, the elders, the entire team at Andrews Memorial Seventh-day Adventist Church for facilitating us, for accommodating us, you know, in the middle of Youth Month, right in the middle of, well, at the end of their week of prayer, allowing us to be here to have this event. We want to say a very big thank you. Thank you to the members of the church for having us here. We'd also like to thank our, We'd also like to thank our music coordinator, Mr. Joel Thompson, for gathering the musicians, getting the folks together. And we'd, of course, like to thank all the singers that we've had from last night until now, they've done a tremendous job. It's truly been a blessing. And in that same vein, we'd like to thank the band, the different members who've been with us from morning till now, you know, the wonderful music that they played for us. We give them a very big thanks for that. And we'd also like to thank the communications team for enabling this whole thing to happen. You know, we of course can't hold everybody in the church due to the different restrictions that are around. So the fact that you guys were able to watch us on the live stream is all because of them. I want to give them a big shout out. In fact, the churches, give them a little round of applause for me. All right, we thank you, we thank you. And we'd like to thank again the speaker for today, Pastor Kemar Douglas. He delivered a powerful sermon. We want to thank him for that. And penultimate, not last, but still not least, we want to thank you guys for coming out, for listening, for participating in whatever way you did. Those present in the church and those listening to us at home, whether in Jamaica or overseas, we want to give a big shout out. And thank you guys for tuning in. We saw several thousand persons had watched the live stream last time we checked. So we want to thank all of you guys for tuning in and for watching us. And last but not least, we want to thank Mr. Junior McNeish for feeding all of us. All right. And again, we just say a big thank you to everyone who was here, everyone who came out, who participated, who helped make this event a success. We say thank you. We look forward to seeing you again. Thank you once again.
So just to end the day, it would not be a true Advent event if we did not sing the Advent Fellowship song.
E is for abundance,
E is for divine,
E is for the heavenland,
E for every time.
For natural,
T is for total. Please describe the thrills we feel in Advent Fellowship.
I'm a part of Advent Fellowship. I'm a part of that great throng. Somehow I get the feeling
that's where we all belong.
Advent Fellowship with a message for these times. Witnessing to the students now, to everyone.
Message for these times.